Warning: chlorine gas is highly toxic. This experiment must be performed in a fume hood and only by an experienced chemist. Greetings, fellow nerds. In this video, we're going to make chlorine gas, a useful oxidant. There are a few ways to make this. The simplest way is to simply mix chlorine bleach and hydrochloric acid. While this does work, it does not produce very much chlorine for the cost of reactants you'll be using. Also, the amount of chlorine produced is rather unreliable as the bleach may be partially decomposed on the shelf before you use it. Now, before I go on to the better and cheaper methods, I need to cover a strange urban legend that too many idiots are falling for. A lot of people think mixing chlorine bleach and ammonia, or urine, will make chlorine. This is absolutely false. As you can see here, there is no yellow chlorine formation. But it is reacting though and producing many different products, including nitrogen gas, and various toxic products such as traces of hydrazine, chloramine, dichloramine, and nitrogen trichloride. So you still shouldn't mix ammonia and chlorine bleach, but understand that it's not making chlorine gas. Okay, onward. The classic method is to get some manganese dioxide and add at least 4 mole equivalents of concentrated 12 molar hydrochloric acid. Heating the mixture will drive the reaction to completion. What's happening is the manganese dioxide is oxidizing the chloride ions to form chlorine gas and manganese chloride. Be careful when doing this. Sometimes I find if you use too much at once, it bubbles over. Okay, so that's the classic method. A more modern approach is to use solid pool chlorinator. This can either consist of calcium hypochlorite, trichloroisocyanuric acid, or sodium dichloroisocyanurate. Using a pressure-equalized dripping funnel, add the appropriate mole equivalent of 6 molar hydrochloric acid, 4 mole equivalents in the case of calcium hypochlorite, or 3 in the case of the isocyanuric acid versions. Now, you might not have hydrochloric acid available, but you can get around that by using sodium bisulfate and sodium chloride salt. Mixing equal amounts of both with enough water to dissolve them will produce hydrochloric acid in situ that will work to generate the chlorine gas. This is convenient if you don't want to keep too much hydrochloric acid around. To test for chlorine gas, you can make a test solution by mixing about 100 mg of starch with about 0.5 g of potassium iodide and 20 milliliters of water. The exact quantities aren't critical. Shake it up to dissolve as much as you can. Dip in a strip of filter paper to soak it up. Now I'm going to cover it to protect it from the chlorine that I'm going to make over here. You can clearly see the chlorine gas above the mixture. Chlorine is denser than air and most of it will just sit there. Now I'll get the strip and dip it into the chlorine gas. As you can see, the chlorine quickly converts the iodide into triiodide that the starch detects as this dark blue or brown color. Okay, I'm going to go a little further and let some of the chlorine fall into the tester solution. As you can see, I didn't even have to pour the chlorine in. Enough is in the air right now to turn the chlorine tester solution dark. I hope this emphasizes again that this experiment must be performed in a fume hood. So that's how you make chlorine gas. I'll be using chlorine gas in later videos as a gaseous oxidant. So please subscribe, like, and comment.